I don't know. Maybe it's just me being old, and I don't know what kids say that much anymore, but I remember when we were upset with somebody because they weren't telling the truth, we had that expression, liar, liar, pants on fire. I really have no idea what it meant or why we said that. We just, that was our way of accusing someone of not telling the truth. However, more and more, liar, liar, pants on fire is something they can really experience, and perhaps it's something they can do. Hey, right now, Interesting Ideas is trying to focus on some of the things that are happening right now, and the artificial intelligence, artificial voice, artificial art, and a number of artificial things can now literally make it true that you don't have to tell a lie. In fact, you can go better. You can even create a lie. Well, there are wonderful opportunities for self-promotion, but there's also a great deal of opportunity for personal destruction. And let's talk about that so we can be smart, savvy, and good, wise, and do our best and avoid the worst that might be out there. I'm Stan Hughes of the program is Interesting Ideas for this Thursday, February 23rd. Hopefully those of you who are in the midst of the blizzard will stay safe and warm. We'll try and give you something to think about for when the weather clears so you can do some good. The program begins right now. By the way, I'm going to show you how you could destroy me if you wanted to. Now, I don't think anybody really want to. It would take a lot of trouble, and I'm not really worth destroying. But if there'd be something that all of a sudden you would decide that you wanted to destroy my reputation, even though I have thousands of videos out there and hundreds and maybe even thousands of radio programs out there, and it pretty well shows me for the best and maybe the worst in whatever point of view. But if you wanted to tell a big lie about me, it would be easy to do because you don't have to tell a lie. You can now create a lie. That's right. You can do that. Let me tell you how that works. What is happening is that here you have me talking. And somebody who would want to could take my voice, and it has all of the idiosyncrasies that make it uniquely mine, and they could take it, break it down, and they could recreate all of the significant sounds, nuances that are there in an algorithm that could create whatever they wanted me to say. That's right. They could create of audio. They could even take all of the pictures of me and put those together. And there I am with my shiny bald head and my spectacles and my rather unique appearance. And they could create me actually saying and performing something. They could create you can hardly even tell the difference between the real me and the fake me in what I might say. And it doesn't take long for you to take those lies that you have created. Remember, they could even create a woman, a person, who does not exist at all. But when you would see her perform and speak, she would look as live as anybody. And she could say some very nasty things about me and testify that they are true. Now, eventually, I could probably prove or point out that that is fake reality, that truly is fake news. But in the meantime, what has it done to me or my business or my reputation? Yeah, that is now what this coming artificial intelligence, artificial voicing, artificial art, artificial creation can do. Now, it has some wonderful possibilities, because actually, I could probably then recreate me doing all kinds of things. I could create me giving a fantastic speech about a subject that I know nothing about. That's right. I could actually take somebody's knowledge and someone's accumulated wisdom, insight, and truth, and the ChatGP will put it all together, and I will have right before me, I've done it, a wonderful little presentation, and I could copy it. And I'm not particularly plagiarizing anybody in particular, but what I'm doing is stealing and plagiarizing from thousands of people whose stuff is out there in the universe, and I'm putting it together using my artificial intelligence, and then being able perhaps to pass it off as my own, and maybe even charge you for the privilege of hearing that. So it could really create a whole lot of revenue and good things for me, because I could be an incredible expert performer on a number of things in which I'm nothing but a charlatan or a fraud, and get away with it. And if I can do it, that means that a whole lot of other people can do it. At the same time, it will allow me, in many cases, if I'm ethical and responsible, to be able to, you know, the search engines are wonderful. You have a question, you can ask it. Now I not only can ask for the information, I can even get that information in the form of a very unique and perhaps well-organized and powerful presentation. And most people would not know. So you see, you can actually today, you don't have to tell a lie. You could actually create a lie. And of course, if you're so inclined and so ethically challenged, you could really become nothing more than a liar. Then you are the liar, liar, pants on fire. Politicians, CEOs, entrepreneurs, all kinds of people who are trying to persuade you that you are something that you may not be, they're going to love this stuff. Well, that's part of the world that will be, and so we better be careful. One of the things we're going to try and talk about is how, in the midst of an AI world, you can truly be different. You can actually be the person that promotes yourself in such a way that there really is no way to duplicate you, at least in what is truly important. I'm Stan Houston. These are random but interesting, focused, and thoughtful thoughts, I believe, about the mess we're in, because it is true. In today's world, you not only can tell a lie, you can create one. That's perhaps enough. 10 minutes for this Thursday. But give me a few more minutes to follow up on some things that might be helpful and useful, and then we'll close it down and ask you to think about how you are going to deal with that world out there. Take care. We'll be back. And the good news is, if you're real, if you truly are like Pinocchio, you're a bit wooden, but you've become real. You're a bit like the Velveteen Rabbit. You're kind of worn out, but now you've become real. Be real. See, the same thing that can create the, you know, personal destruction can also help you promote attraction. One of the messages and mottos behind my life right now is, yeah, I got my start in radio on a 500,000-watt station that boomed around the world, and there's no way in the world that I could control anything about it because it was very expensive, and obviously I was grateful that other people paid the price for my being able to talk around the world. But now, you don't have to have a particular specialty to be able to do that. If you are well-coached and well-trained and well-disciplined, and if you care deeply about being real, and if you care deeply about being honest and ethical and thoughtful and yet humble, if that's who you really are, rather than having you shut down as the loud mouths do all of their talk and the noisy people do all of their stuff, that is possible for you to design a platform, a program, and a way for at least a few people beyond the obvious few that you might know or have could experience your stories, your wisdom, your insight, and your truth. And most importantly, as I often told people, radio is not about information. It is not about entertainment. It is not about all of those things, ultimately. That is how it is used. But ultimately, radio should be and can be a means of communication, not just information and a relentless whatever. It's about communication, and communication is always about relationships. It's about making good friends. And it is about serving an audience. And it doesn't matter. That audience can be one, two, or three. And in fact, that's how you begin. That's another lesson later. But it's a way for you to make good friends. And you don't need many. And how to serve the audience that you have. That's what we do. And I think we do it well. So please reach out to me. Let's try this. Stan@witradio.net. Stan@witradio.net. And then go to our web stage. You see, it's not just a site. It's a stage. It's a platform. It's a performance. And you can get a little bit of a story and perhaps a demonstration of who we are and what we do. And then you can just simply say to me, Stan, I want you to help me. And I will simply say back, how can I help you? And we'll go from there and see what happens. So try that, stan@witradio.net. And remember, be aware, be careful. Don't be one of the bad guys, but be, as the master teacher said, you know, gentle as a dove, but savvy as a snake. Watch out for the bad guys. And watch out for the people who, unfortunately, can not only tell a lie, right now, they can create one. So, all the best and blessings to you. Go out and create good stories, create good things, create good friends. And you know what? See if you can in some way bring a little hope into the world today. Best and blessings, and be strong, be bold, be brave. Speak the truth, do it in love. And have a little touch of humility from time to time. Bye for now.